know you are.
Good evening, everyone.
Let me see here.
Okay.
Hello.
Don't be shy. I see y'all on there. Give us a wave. Say hey.
There's a delay, so they didn't see us yet.
Hold on just a minute. I gotta. Why is this talking over here? Oh, that's no. Hold on. That's why am I not muted over here? Okay.
It happens
to be straight now. Hey. Okay. Say hello, Alyssa.
Hello, Alyssa.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's a long delay today then. Was it short?
Yeah, it is a long delay. So where did Alyssa go to school?
She went to Wesleyan College in Macon, Georgia. Hey, Sandra. Hi, Judy. And then she went to
Georgia College
and got a degree. And then she went to the seminary.
Nice.
Hi, Sue. How are you?
Driven young lady.
Yeah. So she has a 1-month-old.
Is that your first grandbaby?
No, that's my third.
That's your third. I have two. I have two grandbabies.
Okay.
That's what happens when you get pregnant as young as I did. You end up a grandmother before you're 40.
Hey, I'm old to be a first time grandma. You know, all my friends been had kids. Hi, Anna. Thank you for joining us. And hi, Moon Goddess. I'm sorry, I forgot your name, Moon Goddess.
Crystal.
Okay. See,
it's Crystal.
Yeah. So, how's everybody doing this evening?
Yeah. Hey, there's Brenda, Judy.
Thank you.
Hi, Sue. Us.
Brenda, do you see my organized shelves in the back?
It looks so nice. I am so jealous.
I'm working on it. Believe me, you haven't seen my quilting and sewing corner yet. That's my next.
Oh yeah, we're not.
That's
we're not going to show my quilting room. Mm-mm. Yeah.
Well, if you have anything y'all really would like to see this evening, type it in the comments between all the stuff Jan have and the stuff I have. I'm quite sure we can show it to you this evening.
Yep. I didn't bring anything out. So I figured while you were selling, if somebody mentioned, hey, do you have this? It could be like a scavenger hunt for me and I'll go look for it.
Do you have any jewelry? I just have one piece, but Jan will show a few pieces.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, I will.
Yes, I have the hat girls out, Anna. They will be in the show.
Jan will find some jewelry.
Yeah, they'll be in the sale. Anybody else with anything they're looking for in particular? Well, what I'll do is just give a quick rundown of how things is going to work. If you have never shopped with us before, please send us an email with your YouTube name, your real name, your PayPal email, as well as your address.
And thank you. Butterfly Nurse Thrift came over for the first time.
Butterfly Nurse, thank you for joining us and thank you for subbing to my channel. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel or Jan's channel, please do so. What else did I say? Okay, so how it's going to work, we'll show an item, we'll hold up a number, we'll give the price, and the first person to claim it, is who get it. We'll have a few offer-ups. Hi, Katie Sunshine and Lynn. It's been a minute, Lynn, since I've seen you. Welcome back. Thank you for noticing my shelves. You've seen it when it was the other way.
They look fantastic.
I'm trying, believe me. I have this way, we downsize when we move. So this is an adjustment.
You did good.
Okay, so we'll go on then and get started with the first item. Let's see, what are we going to start with? Let's start with these little birds here. Go back to this other screen here. Hold on, just
trying to figure out how to turn that off. How am I making that sound? Who's doing that?
Okay, so we're gonna go with these little birds first.
Mute.
We're gonna start with this little set of birds here. It's an adorable set of little birds.
Oh, how sweet.
It's two pages.
Hi, Lynn.
Right. Here.
This.
These little birds are by, I'll show you the label. Hopefully you can see that. Hold on. Andrea, I never can say her last name. And they measure about, they're about 4 inches tall. There are no chips, cracks, or anything like that. The color is beautiful on them. They're sitting on a branch. There's no chips or anything on the flowers, which is unusual. And this is number 96, number 96, and they are $10. Number 96, and it's $10 for the pair of birds.
Cute, cute, cute.
Now, I have a tendency, I know, to move a little fast. So they're number 96, and it's $10. Lynn, okay, we have you down for that. Thank you. Hi, Dean. Thanks for coming back.
Hi, babes.
Dean is babes.
Dean is babes.
Oh, thank you. Babes.
That's my babes.
Okay. Hi, Jacqueline and Rose. Thank you for joining us.
Miss Jackie with the mom voice.
Let's see what else we have here. Let's stick with some animals for a minute or two, because I know everybody kind of loves to see my animals. The next thing we have is this adorable set of frog salt and pepper shakers.
Those are cute.
Look at that.
Look at how cute those are.
So cute. Hey, Nancy.
Hello, Nancy.
They're about 4 inches tall, so they are a larger set. And look at the eyes. They have pink eyes. They look kind of hand-painted. They do have, they're made in Japan. I don't know if you see that or not, but it is marked on there, Japan. It's actually engraved in Japan, and then it has some writing. And I'm not sure what the writing say, but it's on there. And these are number 44. Number 44, and they're $14 for the pair. Number 44. Hi, precious lavender buttons, Joanne. So these are number 44 for the frog salt and pepper shakers.
I'm gonna go see if I can find some jewelry.
Okey-dokey. So she'll be right back. What I'll do while she's gone till she come back. Let's do that like that. Jan taught me how to do that today, y'all. So real proud of that. Okay, another animal. Let's go with this little golden Labrador retriever puppy. Look at the face. Look at that. He's yarning. And this is by Country Artists for the Disconcerting. And it's made in China. I don't think it's really old. Probably from the 80s or so. But he is very cute. Very cute. And this is number 34. It's number 34, and it is $8. He's $8.
He's such a happy puppy.
And he's kind of a, I don't know if he's at sandcast or whatever, but he's not like a smooth porcelain. And he measures about 4.5 inches tall. That's my favorite kind of dog. But he's really cute. And there's no chips, cracks, or anything like that. So that's number 34. It's the last thing on the other page. That's number 34. Okay. We'll keep it moving. Let's show one more animal, and then we'll go to something else. We'll go to something fun. Look at this set here.
Oh, he's
a
cute.
A little white kitten sitting. He's sitting on a pillow and sitting next to his best bud.
Is that a
How
bank?
How much was he? This was $8. He was $8. And that was number 34. Sandcast was the first company to embrace
resin.
Oh, okay. The quality. And it was, I mean, it's really pretty. Okay, so we got this little puppy, and this is a music box. And there's no chip cracks or anything. And this is by, he put Stand By Me is the song, and it's by the San Francisco Music Box Company. Anna, number 8. Okay.
No, you should have signed her. It was $8.
Oh, Dean, $8. Okay, okay. And this is number.
You don't need any stuff, babes.
Number 42. And it is number 42 is $10. It's $10. I got you, Anna. This was $10, number 42. Now, what would y'all like to see next? Okay. Thank you very much, Anna. Okay, what y'all want to see next? Want to see a vase? You want to see... You want to see jewelry?
I got jewelry.
Okay, show a piece of jewelry.
All right, yes, ma'am. Let me see what I got here. I don't know what I'm looking at. I need my loop. This is a, I've never even looked in this box.
Oh, wrong box, wrong way. I'm trying to get it. I gotta leave it alone.
So this one says, I have no idea what that says.
Trying to get it so she's the big one, but I don't know how to do that.
So up here in this corner, Pat.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. Okay. Okay, there you go.
Pat's gonna have all kinds of guests now because she's all techie. She's gonna go work part-time tech support for StreamYard now. All right, I can't read the name on this, so we'll just wing it. So this is, it's a sweet little candle piece. Let's see if I can put it in front of this. So it's gold tone. I don't see any markings on it that says that it's 18 karat or anything like that. This looks like something that I would like play with and put into a jewelry tree. This is the thing on the back. I don't know if anybody can make out that mark. I can't see it. Sweet little pin, Christmas pin, little red stones, and I think there's some green stones in there. Yeah, there's little green stones underneath it. It's really cute. So we're going to say, I don't know, $8, number 18. $8, number 18, and I'm gonna, I don't know if I can, is it Jerry? Is that what Joanne's asking me? Let me see. I can't read it. Nope, I can't read it. $8 for a little candle brooch. Number 18. Let's see what else I got in this. I haven't even been in this box. How about this thing? That's different. Well, this doesn't have any markings. This is, they look like little, hold on. Little, I don't know, ribbons maybe? And they have little stones on them and links. And I have a ruler somewhere. Let's see. It's like, it's a choker, if that helps. And these are, that's what's on the end of it. It's relatively heavy. And there are no stones missing. And we'll do $8, number 16. $8, number 16 for the choker. What else you got, Pat? You ready? Or you want me to do another one?
Do another one real quick.
Do another one. I'm on it. Let's see what else is in here.
How are the stones set? Are they glued or pronged in?
That's a good question. See, that's why I wanted to try jewelry tonight. I wanted people to teach me stuff. They are, well, I don't know.
They look like they're pronged. Nancy says, Jan, I have so much to teach you.
I know, right? I'm learning on the fly, Nance. Are you impressed?
I think we're all learning together.
Yes. So, I mean, they're pretty sparkly. I don't know. Okay, let me get another one. What else we got in this thing? Oh, man. I need a FaceTime call with Miss Crystal to teach me what all this stuff is. All right, this looks like some kind of blessing coin. This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It looks like it's bronze. And on the back of it is, let's see. I don't know which one Nancy's talking about. 1950s for the other one or for this coin? And the coin says, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. And then there's like 15 more lines, which I'm sure is very, very comforting and sweet. And yes, a religious coin. And it's heavy. So it could be brass or something. So we'll do $8, number 69. On the religious coin. You want me to keep going, Pat?
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. I think I'm doing this right. Nope. Yeah. No, but I don't know how to make me one. I don't know how to get. Oh, it's there. Okay.
You did a great job. Say one. Hello. This is Pat Doodles, tech support, StreamYard.
Okay. This is a little donkey. And what's neat about him, he's a salt and pepper shaker. He has salt and pepper shakers, as well as the thing to hold napkins on this side. and the toothpicks right here. He's in pretty good shape. He has a couple of little boo-boos, but they're very, very minor. Right on the edge of here, there is a little bit of paint that's missing. And I seen something else. Do you see anything else? Well, maybe that was it. Okay. So you get this, and he's a large piece. He is about almost 10 inches long from the tip of the tail to the tip of the nose. This is where the napkins go in here, in this side of the saddlebag. And on this side of the saddlebag is where the toothpicks would go. And then here is where the salt shaker would hang and a pepper shaker.
That is so stinking cute.
And there's no marks or anything on it.
I love that.
Yeah, so he's kind of a big one. And
yes, Miss Nancy.
You see, Melissa. Whoops. I'm sorry, knocked something over. Okay, just a minute. I don't know how where he went. Usually she, okay, right here. And do you want me to do this as an offer up? Okay, so I'll just do this is number 8. It's number 8, and I'm asking $30 for it. This is $30, and it's number 8. So this is number 8, and it's $30. Number 8.
That is really, really sweet. What is happening over there, Miss Pat?
Oh, no, that's not me this time. That was my daughter dropping something. And at the end, we do go back and do a recap over everything.
That's good. Well, somebody just cash out Michael some money.
Oh. Okay, the next item we have is this for that guy. He's fabulous. Multiple. Yes, he got a lot of uses. The next thing we have is this Fenton bud vase, and it is a Vaseline glass. It does glow. I'm going to ask Alyssa to turn the light off for me
real quick. Oh, I love stuff that glows.
Oh, I got this other bright light on right here. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this or not. Let's see. Let me turn this off for a minute. I got so many lights. It really glows good, but I don't know why it's not glowing that much. But I don't know if you can kind of see that or not, but it does glow. We just got lights on everywhere here. Okay, listen, you can turn it back on so I can see this one. And it is Fenton. It has the regular paper label is still on it. It's hand signed. And this bud vase measures about 8 inches tall. There's the detail up close. There's the bottom. And it's like a creamy custard satin kind of finish on it. And this bug vase is $18. Makes $18 on it. And it is number, I guess I need to show a number. It's number 27. Number 27. That's number 27, and it's $18. Thank you, Crystal. That's a really nice. Thanks, Brenda. Appreciate it. So it's really pretty, and it's definitely when it's not as much light. And Karen, thank you very much. And if you could send us your information, I would appreciate it. Just drop me an email. My email address is on the screen. I'll do one more. Did you find some more jewelry?
Oh, I'm digging in this.
Okay, I'll do one more then while you're doing that.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now I got you fancy. Let's do this right here. Let's do this. This is a beautiful Elvis napkin holder. It's from 1997. Try to get that glare off of the label. This is the official little sticker thing saying it's real. And it just says Elvis and Elvis Presley are registered trademarks of the Elvis Presley Enterprises made in China. But you have his picture there.
That is so retro.
You have this here. It'd be great in a retro kitchen.
Uh-huh.
So it's really pretty. And this is like a hot pink. And then it's got the black and white checkerboard all the way around. And this measures about 7.5 inches tall. It holds napkins on this side and napkins on that side. So, I mean, this would be so adorable in a kitchen or even sitting on a shelf like this, just as kind of a piece of artwork, which would be really pretty. And it is about a 4-inch square this way here. It has little feet on it and everything. And how much I have on that, Lissa? I don't know why. Usually I'm more organized. 20. Okay, I was going to do this as an offer up. And the offer is starting at $20 for this Elvis napkin holder. So if you're interested in this item, you would just type in 20. And then if anybody else outbid you out, offer you, you can offer more. So this is Elvis, and it is a napkin holder, and the offer is starting at $20 for this. It holds napkins on two sides. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll come back to that. If there's no interest, we'll come back. Okay, it looked like Jan is ready with a piece of jewelry. You ready? I see you sitting there.
You know, I got the utmost respect for people that do jewelry. This sucks. Wow. I don't know. I'm not finding anything really awesome in here. I almost feel like these are like craft pieces, maybe. Maybe she was going to make something with this stuff.
Well, offer it as a craft thing. If it's craft. If
you think okay. It's craft, then jewelry. Maybe I could fill a jar or something. I have, here's a little, these are enamel, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, it looks like, enamel.
Enamel flower pin. That's what the back looks like.
But is it a pin?
Maybe. No, I don't know. It's got this pokey thing on it. What do you do with that?
It looked like it may have been a beret. No, I don't know.
I don't know.
Nancy, what is that?
Nancy!
Hi, Julia. Maybe Julia knows she sells some jewelry.
Okay, so then I got another piece that we'll put with this one. And it looks like a little piece of enamel flower. I really think these are like craft pieces.
Enamel flower.
Yeah, enamel craft. Flowers. Yeah.
Okay.
And that one.
Sam said it's maybe a head clip.
Oh, yes. That makes sense, the way that the clippy thing is. See the
scarf
clippy
thing? Scarf holder? Yeah, maybe it is a scarf holder. I could see that.
Well,
in the 70s, you have your little scarf on.
Yeah. So.
Judy said maybe for a shoe. Okay. And some red
enamel. Yeah. These look like earrings. and the green flower. Okay. And we got these.
Hi, Blonde by Beauty. Blind by Beauty.
Gold tone, brass tone earring. I'm going to say this is all craft stuff. And then we've got, and I'm going to do them all together.
Is it findings? Like just the main
jewelry findings? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. There's another couple little earrings. Well, they're not little. What do you think? Are they me? I'm thinking no. And we also have, there's one more here that matches. Let me know when you're ready, Pat. I'll just keep on.
Oh, I'm just waiting on you. Hi, Jeannie. Thanks for dropping by.
Well, what are you doing that for? These are different. These are.
Those are pretty.
Those are like a, they almost look like a shell almost.
They look like mother of pearl almost.
Yeah, but they're too light to be any.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, they're not. Mother of pearl would be heavy. And they've got a clasp like this.
Okay, a post on it.
Yeah, a regular post and a post and a clip on those. Okay. So that whole lot of stuff, $3.
How much?
$3. Number 67. $3,
number 67.
And I've got a whole bunch of ball jars here. Not the cool ones with the glass tops, but the screw tops. And if anybody wants, I'll put it in a ball jar.
Okay. Butterfly Nurse had claim number 67.
Okay. Let me get my little jar. All right. You want me to do another one, Pat? Are you ready?
Go on and do another one.
I'll do another one. Okay. This one we'll call like a gold tone lot.
Okay, a gold tone lot.
A gold tone lot. We have, and I do think that these are, like I said, craft pieces. So these are little swirly things.
Fancy.
You like my description?
Yeah, that was too cheap. That was. That
Nancy was Nancy is sitting like this right now. Ready, Pat? Nancy is like this. Going, I should have called her. I should have called her and asked her what she was doing tonight. All right, so the swirly things. Now, I'll tell you one thing, Pat. I love metal looking stuff. So I want to make like pin boards where you pin all the jewelry or you glue pieces of jewelry all together.
Uh-huh.
So matchy-matchy things like this are good for that. It has, yeah. You know, just a, these look like some kind of scarf pins too.
And with pins like that, also what else is beautiful, my daughter's wedding, I used all kinds of vintage pins from her, both for her grandmothers to make her bouquet.
Oh, nice. So
wedding's coming. That would be a great assortment.
Yes. All right. And then we've got two. I mean, I would like make birds out of. Wow. Look at those are perfect brows for me. Right. No. These are also earrings. One's missing a post. So I'm thinking definitely craft stuff.
Also great for mixed media pieces.
Yep. I think that's what we're going for here. This one is a little tiny pin with a picture frame in it.
That's very pretty.
And this one's a little heavier, so it's not like cheap stuff, but I don't see any mark on it.
Jan is using filters.
I wish Crystal and Nancy had like a buzzer where they could like, you know, buzz me when I'm giving away the farm or something.
Well, you know what my daughter do is she just sends me a text message.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
That's a good idea. All right. We got another little piece that looks like that one. So put that in there. Okay. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces. got another brooch that's gold.
This lot is more than $3, okay, y'all?
Whatever, is it? Okay, what is it? That one says something.
You're not seeing it.
That one says...
But Nancy was saying, I know earlier I seen her say, no, not jars. They're too heavy. Use Ziploc bags.
Okay, Ziploc bags. That says...
That one has a maker's name.
Yeah, this one does have a maker's name. I'm looking. Something BSK? BSK? You're supposed to be schooling me, Pat.
I'm lost on jewelry. I don't do jewelry. I got, you know.
Well, apparently I don't do jewelry. Okay, so this one's going in there. And this one is definitely heavier. So I would say.
Okay. To give you a comparison on the BSK jewelry.
Yeah.
Most of the pieces are at least $15. On or $7.99 and stuff. So that is a signed piece, and that's some vintage jewelry from the 50s and 60s, some of it.
Neat. And then we got these little, and these are not, there's no weight to these whatsoever. So these are craft too. So we've got craft pieces and one good piece. And you said they're going for like 15, this one, Pat?
One similar to that, I do see 15 on it on eBay.
Okay, so we'll say 10 bucks for the pile.
Okay, so that's a, and what's that number?
This number is 65.
Number 65, and it is $10.
Is anybody sorry they asked me for jewelry yet? I could go hunt for something else.
Okay. Anybody out there? I mean, that's a great deal. Are there more cookbooks that you would like, Sue? Somebody want to see? Okay, Nancy have that one. Congrats, Nancy. I'll show you.
Nancy, my Nancy? My sister Nancy?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you want to see some cookbooks, I have plenty of cookbooks.
Me too.
Yeah, I mean, I got like a ton of them right down there behind Terry's box. Okay, let me go back like that. Okay. So she's going to pull out some of those. And let's see what else.
That's what I'm after now. I got to go look for cookbooks.
It must be down there. Yeah, it must be over there. Don't worry about them then. Okay. Don't worry, they're over there. Okay, so while she's going to look, I am going to pull out the next item. Let's do these little girls. These are really cute.
What am I looking for, Pat? Cookbooks?
Cookbooks.
Yes, ma'am. I'm on it.
Okay. Okay, so we have this adorable little girl here. They look a lot like Yadros, but they are not. They're just made in China, but they were so cute when I seen them. So this little girl is holding on to her hat. And look at that detail. Butterfly nurse before you. Okay, I will do that. I'll get my daughter to check. Look at that last one to see whether it was Nancy or butterfly nurse. And there's the face up close. I mean, she is so gorgeous. I mean, look at the flirty eyes. I mean, just really nice detail in all of this here. Yeah, this is vintage. Any vintage gardening books? You know, I do. I think Alyssa, I see it. Okay, Alyssa wants to say she see it. So we'll have to make a note on that.
Yeah, and then...
37. Okay. She's okay. Make a note on that paper so we can let her know. And this here is number 97. And before I tell you how much, let me tell you how tall she is. She's about 10 and a half inches tall. And she has beautiful detail. Look on the head. I mean, this flower is like perfect. There's no marks or anything on her. She's just plain, but it's really pretty. And this is number 97, and it is $20. Number 97, and it is $20. Number 97, and it's $20. Dance off. It would be a train wreck on my end. Okay. So we have that little girl there. And then we have her sister as well. Her sister or her best friend. Okay, I have you down for that one. Thank you, Anna. And for everybody that shops Saturday, if you're wondering where your invoices is, you know, I usually get them out the next day, but since I'm going to start having sales on Tuesday nights, I will get your invoice out on Wednesdays. And then we have this one here. And she's holding her hat. And look at that hair. I mean, the details on these is just really, and she has a real dainty kind of demure, like little smile. And she is about, oh, okay. Thank you, Sam. She's about 9.5 inches tall. So she's a little bit shorter. I'm excited too. Jan is teaching me so much about how to use this StreamYard thing. You know, I'm new at this. Okay, now this one, her little flower do have a couple little chips on it, but really it almost, if you didn't feel the sharpness, you would think the flower just looks like that. So for that reason, this one is number 32 and she's $15. Number 32 and she's $15. But they make a perfect pair, the two of these. I mean, they're really pretty together. And this one's a little bit taller because of her hat. You back yet? Okay, I'll do one more thing and then we're going to switch over. Did you find some cookbooks?
I did.
Okay.
I have about 300.
Oh, okay. I have a whole bunch of them. My kids said they wanted them. And then after I moved them up here, they decided they took a few. Okay, I'm going to do this little angel, then I'm going to switch it back over. This is a Jim Shore angel. She's really pretty. There's the markings on the bottom. And this one is called Angel of Love, and it's from 2002. And she has cute little birds, which would be perfect for spring. Beautiful bird houses all the way around. And she's about 9 inches tall. There's no chips, cracks. Her paint is in, I mean, great shape, immaculate. And this is number 9. It's number 9. And she is number 9. And she is $20 for this Jim Shore angel. And that's number 9. Number 9, and it is $20. Okay. Sheila, thank you. And if you've never shopped with me before, if I don't have your information, if you would just drop me an email with your information on it, I would appreciate it. Thank you. Okay. It's all yours.
Okay. So I'm getting messages that Butterfly Nurse Thrift got
yes.
that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Mm-hmm. Got it. All right. Cookbooks. This is fun for me to be able to say, I want to look at this and see how fast I can go find it.
Okay.
I like that. All right.
I know we're going to get to the vases. We're going to get to them. We have some.
So I have Gooseberry Patch, Welcome Home for the Holidays. We showed this at our sale and sold one. I have more of them, and they are in pristine condition. $3. Number 62. And I have two more.
What she has.
Who?
Jan.
Oh, I'm just typing it in the notes.
Sue Spezio, I see you. Gooseberry Patch cookbooks. Yep. So I have two more. If anybody else wants the Gooseberry Patch cookbook, put number 62. All right. Next, I have the French Chef Cookbook, Julia Child. And this is definitely not signed, almost brand new condition, Mastering the Art of French Cooking, 1962, Julia Child. And this one, and it's got some pictures inside of Julia when she was young. So this cookbook, I'll just do like an offer up. I'll just start this at $5. I don't know what it's worth. Cool pictures. Anybody ever see that movie with the woman that made all of the recipes from Julia Child? Orange glaze. Lilacs Vintage Life, I see you. Judy Gillespie, I also see you. What else we got here? Oh, it's all, the names are in French. The book is in English, but the names are in French. I can't say these words. Oh, they have the translations. Provençal Garlic Soup. Mold of ice cream with rum and chocolate. Dinner for 4.5 hours.
Judy's at 10.
What else we got in here? Roast suckling pig. Petites pots de crème à chocolate. This is fancy. Filet de mornay, simple fish stock, how to do fish stock, chicken stock, turkey stock. It's Julia Child's after all. French onion soup, good stuff in there. So where are we at?
The high bid right now is Lilac Vintage Life, I believe, with 12.
For $12?
Yes.
Looks to be in very nice condition. Oh, it does have a little chunk out of the paper on the corner there. So we'll, you want to call it, Pat?
Okay, what I'll do is, let's give it 30 seconds. What I normally do is put my timer on and give it 30 timer. Seconds.
Timer is fancy.
Just a moment. Not timer. Reset. Okay, I'm going to go back screen like that.
And you're so fancy. Start.
So we'll see whoever is
going one. About. So that timer's
so we have about 20 seconds.
Going twice. Julia Child 1961 cookbook sold to Christina for $12.
Okie dokie, stop. So
that's neat. I've never used a timer. You're teaching me stuff.
$12.
All right.
Okay.
You want me to do another one?
Yeah, and then I did find one cookbook and another book that have some recipes in it. That's not a cookbook, though.
Okay.
But it's got this great. One.
Who asked me to go hunting for cookbooks? Julia? This one is The Chicken Cookbook by Beverly Sias. And this one is 1969, printed in the United States. The Chicken Cookbook, Beverly Sias. And this has chicken tacos, Southwest chicken, Cajun fried chicken, Pennsylvania Dutch chicken, chicken Creole, Creole rice. We'll do the same. What did I do on the last one? Started at five. Let's do the same thing. Yes, $5. Fried chicken and Virginia ham. Curry. Chicken Raphael wheel. Chicken a la Ritz. Chicken with chestnuts. Chicken with celery. Chicken coriander. Pineapple chicken with rum.
I love me some chicken. That's what.
I'm getting them hungry. That's a bad thing. Breast of chicken with cream. Anybody? Nobody's interested in that one. I got more. I'll put a number on that. We'll just say $5, number 52.
$5, number 52.
Yep. I'm going to put that number right in there. And one more here. This one is Secrets of Modern French Cooking. And Oliver, La Cuisine. It's also a hardcover, and it has the jacket on this one. And this one is also 1969. Soups and stocks, hors d'oeuvres, eggs, fish, shellfish, meat, poultry, game, vegetables, desserts, sauces, wines, cheese. This is another one. We'll just start at $5. And his name is Raymond Oliver, Secrets of Modern French Cooking. If you're going to see, you better bring me some.
Bring everybody some back.
Raymond Oliver, La Cuisine, $5. That cookbook cover is the angle when you turn. What? Cookbook cover is the angle when you turn on your front facing camera. True story. Original babes. Okay, $5 on that one, and we'll call that one number 35.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Your turn.
Okay.
You gotta tell me what to go for now.
Okay. I will I guess I'm hitting the wrong thing. Okay. So the cookbook that I'll have. And again, I will start it at $5 offer up. It's Dinner in a Dish Cookbook by Betty Crocker. It has a spiral binding, so it lays flat when you're cooking. It has beautiful pictures in it. And this was from 1974.
Babes likes
pictures. 1974. It has lots of recipes. Only thing is the recipes are like those little drawing. I mean, the pictures, they aren't. But they're in great shape. All of them have recipes for everything. Give you some examples. They have fast and favorable recipes in here. So if you come home from work, you need to hurry up and cook something. This is the index. A little bit of everything. Oh, there's some chili.
Ooh, chili.
Oh, color pictures.
Babes loves pictures. We go to a restaurant. If the menu has pictures, he gets all excited.
How about chicken and rice with champagne sauce? Don't think that is in this book. The Betty Crocker stuff is kind of plain usually, but you have some great cheese cloud on creamy chicken. Have no idea what that is. Doesn't sound.
That sounds fantastic. How much is this book, Pat?
It starts at $5. It's an offer up for the Betty.
Okay.
Crocker. Dinner and a dish cookbook.
I'll offer $5.
We have Sue at $5. We have Sue at $5. Offer up Betty Crocker cookbook. Now, when I'm spelling these words wrong, I'm trying to, did I spell her name wrong? Yeah.
Say whose name wrong? Betty Crocker?
No, I'm saying when I'm spelling these names wrong, I'm like trying to do that with one hand and concentrate on this. Okay, so we have Sue at $5. If there's no other interest, I will say sold to Sue at $5. So that's Sue at $5. I'll put your name on it. Thank you, Sue.
You're getting good with that camera.
I do have your item in my box ready to ship when I start shipping on Thursday. So that way that can go in the box with your little bank. And then the other thing is not a cookbook, but it has recipes in it. It is an old woman's home companion from 1955.
Ooh, ah.
1955.
Look at those little chicks on there.
Yeah, this is April, so it's Easter issue probably. They were at that time 35 cents. This would be great for junk journaling.
Oh, wow.
Everything. Okay, let me find some recipes. Who remembers Carol syrup?
Don't forget to make me small, Miss Pat, so you can show off that magazine.
Oh, make me- I guess I
yeah.
Okay, hold on. Listen.
You got this. Perfect.
Okay. Oh, I didn't stop my timer. But it does have recipes. Look at this right here. But look at this one right here. The most beautiful girl in the world. Look at that. I mean, the graphics in these magazines are
wonderful. Aren't they?
Here are some recipes for spring desserts. I mean, this says spring, but they'd be great for summer as well. And this is the offer up, and I'm starting it at only $5.
Nice.
Look at this right here, the mother and child. Let's find a recipe. I've seen a lot of recipes before I started. And look at this cheer.
You got a $5 bid from Lilac's Vintage Life.
Okay.
Which is Christina.
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 Whose parents or who had this furniture in their living room?
Mm.
Everybody seems like I know.
That's nice. What was the year on that?
This is 1955, April.
Oh yeah, that's how you get Christina.
Now look at this right here. Now this is kind of expensive for 1955. So this was some upscale furniture. Look at the colors. Does that look familiar?
Wow.
This was $200 for that furniture back in 1955.
Cute.
Did I receive your information? Probably. I can look and see in a minute. Yeah, but these got some wonderful graphics and stuff in it. Some baby oil. People even still use baby oil.
Look at that bum. Did you see that little baby bum?
Yeah. Look at that kitchen. Very retro. Very mid-century modern.
MCM. Christina has been teaching me that acronym. MCM. Hey. Mid-century modern.
Hey, Book. How are you?
Hey, Book.
And here is Grace Kelly. Look at that. She is so elegant.
Wow.
Okay,
I think so you can start calling that one.
Yeah, we're gonna call this one, and it looked like it is Christina at $5.
Am I supposed to get more cookbooks?
What are we doing? That's up to you.
What else you got?
What else? I have what else do I have? Let's see.
Your shelves look so nice. Cookbooks. Okay.
How about, this is not a cookbook, but it's got the word cook in it, because it's cookies.
Nice.
It's a vintage Mickey Mouse cookie tin.
Cute.
It has the plastic lid on it. It's in pretty good shape on the inside. And it is by, let me show you the bottom. What's that?
Is it tin?
Yes, it's a tin. Say
that. Okay.
I don't know. It's like Cheinco, Chinco Company Housewares. It's by J. Chin and Company. It's out of Burlington, New Jersey. This is the bottom.
Very nice.
It's as big as my head. So it's about 8 inches tall without the lid, and in diameter it measures 7 inches. And this is the plastic lid, and it is marked as well, labeled. And this is, what's the number on that, Lisa? I mean, not the number, but the...
I just say thing with the stuff.
Yeah. Okay. $20. This is number 46. Number 46, and it is $20. Number 46, and it's $20 for the Mickey 10 cookie.
Look at your cute little cards with your email address on. You're so fancy.
Yeah, it sounds like my granddaughter. She's always said, Meemaw, I'm so fancy. So that was the Mickey cookie 10. Number 46 for $20.
Very nice.
Okay. You have something ready?
Do another one and I'll go find something.
Okie dokie. Okay, let's do this Raggedy Ann tea set. It is service for four. It has a teapot, four cups, four saucers, creamer, and sugar. And this is by another one of those names that I don't say well. And this was put out in, it's by Simon & Schuster. It's licenses, but I forgot what year, and I didn't know what year this was. And this is how much? Right here. $15, number three. $15, number three for the Raggedy Ann tea set. It's a cute little piece to add to any collection. And that was number three. Number three. Number three. Okay, let's go with this little thing here. While we're waiting on Jan to come back, we'll go with this little July birthstone girl. Okay, Becky is vintage. Number for that, Lisa. Becky is vintage.
Okay,
let me finish this one up and then I'll switch back. Oh, we have this little,
you go right ahead.
She is a little figurine, she's about 4 inches, a little bit more than 4 inches tall. And her little flower is chipped right there. But she is, look at the face on her. She's really cute. And she's made in Taiwan. I think that's what it said. Can you see that?
It's not Taiwan.
Made in Taiwan. And this little birthstone girl is birth month girl is $8. You see it on your list? And it's number 19. Number 19 for the July girl. Okay, yeah. And that's number 19. Do you have any January figurines? I will look while Jan is on. I'll look and see if I have any January. And that's for Sue. Thank you, Sue. I appreciate it. Okay, I'll set that right there with your other book. Okay, Jan's not back.
I'm coming.
She's coming. Okay. I'll go on and do this while we're waiting on Jan. This is a beautiful little footed pedestal, little trinket tray, trinket dish. It's by Limoges, France. I don't know if you can see that. It has beautiful flower designs up there. And this is number 4. And it is $12, number 4. And this measures about a little bit more than 5 inches around this way.
Do you have any more of those purses from the other day? That's what somebody
Do said. I have any more of the purses? Oh, hippie purses. I have to go look. Let me check. And this is about 3 inches tall. It's number 4 and it's $12. Number 4 and it's $12. Okay, Jan is back. I'm going to turn it over to her.
Okay. I found some gourmet magazines. These are pretty cool.
Yes.
All right. 70. Oh, cool. Okay. So we have, these are gourmet magazine. I have 7 of them from 1978. Gourmet magazine from 1978. And this is, they're not as old as Miss Pat's magazine, but they have recipes and ads. So we have June. We have October. These are gourmet magazine, and they've got fancy pictures of fancy foods. Going with the cookbook theme. Oh, my babes would eat that. Look at that. Pasta possibilities.
Okay.
Lots of pretty pictures of fancy foods. So these at $6. That's a dollar a piece. November 1978. This one's got breads on it. Look at those Waterford crystal decanters. I bet you I got a bunch of those in here. Some cute ads. Some articles about places with fancy cuisine. 70s advertisements. Meal prep display presentation. So that one is November. Tell me when you're ready, Pat.
Oh, no, go on.
Okay.
Good.
December, I'm just hanging out, making sure you're practicing your StreamYard skills. I like the pieces of furniture in some of these. That's a big bird right there. So that one's December of 78. So that is Christmas stuff. April of 78. Really cool rooster on the front. Oh, there's pictures of castles in here. Some different. I know my mom collected these because she wanted to see the glassware that they were using to present meals on. And that's how she dated a lot of the glassware. Hmm. February 78. There's more glassware. There's a lot of advertisements for Waterford crystal, which there's quite a bit of that in this house, I have found. And then pictures of like basket presentations.
Their photography was just wonderful in that magazine.
Yeah. Well, these were people that enjoyed cooking, you know? Not me.
Well, I cooked a wonderful dinner this evening, including strawberry shortcake, and I actually made the shortcake.
So this is all about food presentation.
So how much is that lot? Is it going to be a lot or?
They're a buck a piece. Yeah, $6, starting at $6.
Okay, so six.
And then the last one here is May 78. And again, this is how she was finding out about glassware, silverware. This is like the type of stuff that made her discover oyster dishes. Have you ever heard of an oyster dish, Pat?
No.
Apparently, they're really pricey. Mm-mm. You find an old dish that is got spots for oysters. They're different than eggs. Oh, look at those fancy things.
So is my portion in the mail, Pat. Oh, of the strawberry shortcake. Unfortunately, I never eat two pieces. I ate two pieces tonight. Then my husband had two pieces. My son-in-law had two pieces. And I made them all. Is it any interest in the magazine lot? It's a great deal because the photography in there is wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is a longer oval than eggs. All right, Miss Pat, show me your camera skills.
Okie dokie.
Right. Look at that. Smooth transition.
Someone asked about a January angel or a January figurine. I have May. Ooh. I have August. And I have a February, but I did not see any Januaries right off. Not to say I don't have any. So if it's any interest in any of those, just let me know and I will, put them up. Hi, how many magazines? It was six magazines.
Yep, it was six.
Yeah, so that's $1 a piece.
Mm-hmm.
Which, like I said, that's a great price because those magazines, how much were they when, what was the cover price on there? About $6 even then?
No, these are older. These were 50 cents.
Oh, 50 cents. Okay, so they're old. Okay.
Yeah, they're old.
Yeah, they're pretty old.
Oh, the 78 ones say $1 on them.
Dollar, okay. Because they're $1. Pretty, okay. So you have an offer on that?
Oh, thank you, Ninja Writers. If I find the other six of that year, I'll add them if you're interested. Just email me, antiquesfromkaren@gmail.com, your YouTube name, your real name, your shipping address, and your PayPal address, por favor.
Okay.
I've never seen your info. Unless you did today, while we've been live.
I'm challenging. Okay.
Ooh. Can I see May?
Can you see May?
She wants to see May. May, okay. Angel.
The May Angel.
Okay. Yes.
Miss May has an issue, but I think she turned out adorable, okay? I did not notice until I actually pulled her out the other day that her wings were broke off. So I replaced her wings with this beautiful tool. Other than that, she's in perfect shape, perfect condition. Like even this little spaghetti type trim, none of that is chipped off or anything. Her gold is, I mean, it's really nice. It just has numbers on the bottom. And this May Angel would be number 43, and she'll be $8. Number 43, $8 for the May Angel.
Make me little, Pat.
Okay, make you little.
You got this. You got this.
Okay. So it looked like butterfly.
Butterfly nurse thrift. Okay. Butterfly nurse thrift. Yep.
Number 43.
Speaking of repair, Miss Pat, perhaps you should tell these people how much you're a certified doll doctor.
Yeah, if you notice on my invoices, a lot of times it'll be Doll Maker's Delight, because what my primary job is and what I enjoy most. Well, I enjoy thrifting a whole lot, okay? But I also make dolls, and I teach doll classes. I've taught, you know, almost all over the country and so forth. So I really enjoy doing that as well. But I just got junk in, and I just love it.
Now, you have a booth somewhere, right?
I have a booth at the Sanford Antique Mall in Sanford, North Carolina.
Very
also,
nice.
Also, I sell on Etsy, and also I've sold on eBay. I hadn't been doing eBay recently. I stopped having a store when I was moving. Thank you. I think it turned out adorable, a little deep, you know, adding that on the back.
Yes.
So
she knows how to repair.
And I mean, if nobody told you, because I mean, you cannot look up under there to see where it was broken or anything. It just looked like that's the way it was supposed to be. But
so
she's really cute.
Kendra Drow is asking, worked with a birdie.
What is a birdie?
It's a type of doll, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a type of doll?
Oh, no, I'm not familiar with a birdie. I used to do appraisals for insurance companies when people wanted to have their doll collection valued, or if it was, you know, in case of a fire or anything like that. I used to do values for them.
Ooh, you want a job, Miss Pat?
I would do it for you, but I'm not like one, like, you know, I told you I'm coming up that way to visit for real.
All right.
Yeah. Her first name. I'm going to look that up. Send me an email, Kendra Jo, and I'm going to look that up and see.
Kendra Jo is a fountain of knowledge.
Yeah, send me an email and I would look and see. I'd like to research that and find out more. Okay, so that was those there. What else do I have here? I didn't pull out like a lot, so we're kind of like winging it.
That's all right. If you want to play with more buttons.
Yeah, we're kind of all over the place.
Welcome to my world.
I have this, I don't know what you call it, candy dish or what. I believe it's by Fenton. Some things I see say Fenton, some don't, you know, didn't have a name at all. It does have a few little chips. Not on that part. I thought it was on that part. You can stop by New Jersey. Okay. You put the coffee. Make mine tea, though.
They want to travel.
Yeah. Right around here, I don't know if you're able to see it. Can you see that little teeny nick out there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. On that lid, it had a couple of little issues, but it's still, I mean, it's so pretty.
Oh, look at the paint on there.
Hand painted around there. And then that's, if you pretty notice the design here.
Yeah.
With my hand up.
What design is that? Depression glass?
Well, it said frosted Fenton glass is what I've seen several people.
Oh, yeah. Totally different. Yeah.
And I mean, you know, people on eBay aren't always right, you know, but.
No.
That's and then
what's your starting price?
The starting price on this starts at $15 is the starting price. And this measures, with the lid, it measures about 9 inches tall.
That's beautiful.
And like I said, in perfect shape condition, this would sell for a lot more.
Mm-hmm.
Without the lid, it's about 6 inches. And in diameter, it's about 6 inches. But this part here is in really, really good shape. There's a little tiny, no, it's not a nick there. This part is no nicks, no crack, no chips or anything. But on this lid, probably, you know how people would just slam stuff down. Thank you. Is it Christina?
Yep, that's Christina G.
Okay.
But okay. She changed it to Lilac's Vintage Life because she has a new channel.
Okay, I'll be sure to go over into and sub to your channel as soon as we get off here. I'll be sure to go
prepare over to be blown away.
Yeah.
Cool stuff.
So I'm not going to hold it too long, but we got 15. Is it any other interest on this? Okay, so I'm going to say sold to Christina for $15. Okay, you have something, Jan?
I can if you want me to. Did you pick a Here's something.
Okay.
I haven't looked them up. They are brown 1994. This one's 1994. This one's 1987. Brown bag cookie art. They're a stone. So it's a stoneware.
It's like a cookie press.
Yeah, but they're heavy. They're square.
Yeah.
Says
all decor too.
And that's what the little book. So they both have the little book on them.
Mm-hmm.
They were originally
thank you, Kendra Jo.
$14 each. And they have little booklets with all the different stuff you can make with them. They're pretty cool. You can do baker's clay. So this one is an angel, I think. Flying angel. And this one is a bear with a scarf and a Christmas present. And I'll do, $8 for both of them.
Oh, that is such a deal for anybody that.
$8, number 49.
That's a great
really
deal.
Fancy. But I don't have any place to put them without them getting broken. So they need to go now.
Yeah, that is such a good deal on those.
Number 49.
Yeah. Or if you decide you want to put them online, they sell really, really well on Etsy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Sue has them. Thank you, Sue.
Thank you, Miss Sue. What else got?
What else? Okay. You ready? You want me to go?
You go.
Okay.
Your fancy camera action.
Okay. We're going to go with this Jim Shore dog. Really nice. His pieces are so nice and very collectible. And I'll show you the bottom. And this one was from 2005. But look at all the detail. And let's see. This is number 94. Thank you. And it is $15 for the Jim Shore dog. Those pieces are really hard to find. I've only found a few of the like the different character ones. But that's number 94 and it's $15. And then I'll do this and then maybe Janet will be ready. I have this piece of glass here, this glass art. It looks like Murano glass. I'm not sure if it is or not. I just thought it was just very, very interesting.
That's gorgeous.
And this is about 8.5 inches tall from this point up here to the bottom. There's no marks or anything like that on it. But it is just really, really pretty. I don't know if the camera really does it justice, but it is really pretty. And this is number 37, and it is $15. Number 37, and it's $15. Number 37, and that's $15. But that is just so, okay, Book, we have you for 15. Thank you. And if you would send me your information, I may have it. I'm not sure. But if you would just, wouldn't mind just send it to me again, please, I'd appreciate it. Okay, so now, Jen, are you ready? Okay, she's gone. What else do I? Okay, let's do this while we're waiting on Jan to come back. Look at this cute. Wait, is that a crack? No. This little poodle. And this is by, how do you say that? Thoroughly?
I think so.
It's like a really fine porcelain. And it's made in England. And I can show you, there's the little label on it. And it's small. He's about almost 5 inches long and about 3 inches tall. The flowers are in really good shape. I'm feeling over it. I don't think there's any chips or anything on it. It may be a little. Yeah, it might be one right there. I'm not sure. Please, regular payroll for me. And I do appreciate it. It allows me to go shopping and get more stuff. So this is really pretty. And this is number 85. And it's $12. Hi, Yvonne. Thank you. Yeah, this is really cute. He's a little dusty. But I mean, it is really cute. It's number 85 and it's $12. $85. Are you back yet, Jan? No. Okay, let's go with this little Fenton bear. It's a September bear. It's by Fenton. Make sure you give, thank you. Yes, please give us a thumbs up, excuse me. And this is made by Fenton. Still have the label on it and has a little blue heart. And the Fenton bear is number 38 and it's $10. I'll kind of hold that behind for you to see. So that's for the Fenton bear. And it is a September. Okay. Is she back? No. Okay, we'll keep it moving then. I'm not sure. Okay, Yvonne got that one. Okay, I have that down for you.
The t-shirts and you sell the book is that book is asking about.
I need a t-shirt. The t-shirts, that's the black one that says Junkin' I'm ready. I'll put a link down there for that. Put that one down, the Fenton Bear. Okay, I'm not sure. I would call this like either a small planter would look great with a planter in it, or maybe a toothpick, but it's a white porcelain. It has beautiful flowers around it, and all of these flowers are in, yeah, they're in great. No, it looked like one might be missing from right there. I'm not sure. It's no marks or anything on it. Somebody's name was on it. And it's just an adorable little owl. And it's number 36 and it's $5. Number 36 and it's $5. Okay, and I see Jan is back. Number 36 and it's $5. Okay. Yeah, but this is really, I mean, this is a very, very nice porcelain.
He's cute.
Okay, so let's go here. And you ready?
Ready for what? What do you want? Pick what a cat.
What you got?
I got bunnies. You want bunnies?
Okay. Bunny.
I got two little bunnies. Let me make my screen big so the light isn't so bad. There, that's better.
Yeah, that's better.
Two little bunnies with pink eyes. And they don't have anything on the bottom of them.
He's fussy.
Okay.
But Nancy will usually tell me what they are. They are two itty bitty bunnies, $9 for the pair. And they are number 31. They look Lefton. Yeah, I think they are Lefton. But the other Lefton bunnies I had, they didn't have the shine on them.
Let's see the bottom. Well, Lefton have some shiny ones too. It's no marks on the bottom.
Mm-mm.
Vintage. I'm so addicted. I'm not. You're not the boss.
Nancy told me to make t-shirts that say hashtag the dirt is free. Babes get so mad at me. I'm so bad at cleaning this stuff up. I'm just like, woo, let's sell it. So little Lefton bunnies, if they are.
Character.
Yes. $9 for the bunnies. What else do you want me to do? I get Christmas. Does anybody want Christmas stuff?
It's May. Yeah.
So
you can do a
Babes and I are doing a sale tomorrow night at 8:00. I haven't posted the thing yet, but we're bringing a lot of Christmas stuff in.
Okay.
I don't see anybody asking for anything. That's what I'm gonna do.
Do that owl right there in the back of you. That's cute. See that owl?
Oh, he's in the sale tomorrow.
Oh, that's for your sale tomorrow. Oh, okay.
Yeah. I got a little lion.
Some vases. Okay, I'll pull a few of those down since you asked for that.
Vases. Karen wants vases. I got vases.
Okay.
This is a little Crown Royalty or something, and it's a bank, and the little sound that's on the inside is the stopper.
This is a cute little one. Get these two right here down.
And he is $6. Number 46. $6, number 46.
That's cute.
And he is, you know, that big.
Did you show that before?
He was in another sale that I did, but he didn't sell.
Okay.
So I wanted to see if anybody here wanted them. So price in half. And what else you want me to do?
What you got?
You got to pick a category.
Well, they asked for vases. Do you have any ready that you can pull?
Do your camera trick. Make me little. You're getting so good at this.
And I'm going to show I have one. Are you going to go and get yours?
I'm going to go get a vase. Okay.
I have this beautiful bud vase here. Oh, that's really nice. The way the light hits that. I like that. I know nothing about it. It's no marks or anything on it. It's about 8 inches tall. And it's pretty, about 2.5 inches going across this way here. And for this vase here, I would say $10. I'm not sure anything about it. Let me try to shine some more light on it to see if I can see something else. No, it's just pretty. Yeah, so this vase would be $10. And then the other vase I have is this little short one here. It's a pottery vase. It's only about 4 inches tall. There's the mark on the bottom of it. It's made in India. And it says hand. I don't know what that means. But it's just a cute little vase. This would be $6. That would be $6. Okay. Is she back yet? Hello. Sorry I'm late. Work. Missed the sale. We're still going for a while. While she's gone, since she's not back yet, have this adorable chicken on a basket, and it is a salt and pepper shaker. It's not old or anything, but it's cute. So it's a chicken salt and pepper shaker. And let's see where it's at on my list. It's number 5. It's number 5, and it is, let's see what the price is on it. This is $10 for the salt and pepper shaker. The color is very nice on it.
Hi, Rebecca.
Okay, so that's $6. I mean, $10, number 5. Okay, you got something ready?
I got something. I went and got a vase.
Okay.
I got 2 vases. You're so fancy. Look at you with the camera. I have a clear glass vase, and I'm going to need a tape measure.
My internet is going out saying I'm having streaming issues.
All right, got a tape measure.
All I have left is that right there.
This is a clear, clear swirly vase. And it is 9 inches tall, 4 inches on the top, 3 inches-ish on the bottom. No chips, no cracks. And we'll do $6.40. $6, number 40. How about now? Do you guys hear an echo now? Did we fix the echo?
It's not as bad.
I don't hear an echo.
I'm excited. Fingers crossed.
Okay. And then I got another one.
Hi, Rebecca. Maybe I just miss seeing you. Hi.
This one's really kind of cool looking. This one is
information. Got Kendra and Yvonne.
This one is 7 1/4-ish.
That's unusual.
Isn't that unusual?
And it reminds me of the Kool-Aid pitchers.
And it's also like not. It's like there's bubbles in it.
Mm-hmm.
There's bubbles in a couple spots, and it's not like perfectly. I don't know. It's very art like. I don't see a seam on the side, and I see other bubbles in it. There is a small circle. I don't know if they did like a pontil mark, but that, I mean, it doesn't look like it to me. I don't know. I don't know enough about it, but it's got flowers and leaves, and it's all very, and it's a heavy glass. It's not a lightweight glass. So we'll also say $6 for this one, number 29.
Pretty good.
Neat looking.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Your turn.
Okay. Let me go back here.
Good girl.
Okay. I only have two things left. I'm going to do this. And then the last item, of course, is one of the lady vase heads, and it'll be an offer up. But a couple of weeks ago, I had some deer and several people were interested. But these ones are even nicer because they have so much detail in the eyes and in the ears and everything. So it's a set of two. And they're a good weight brass. One has kind of got his head down. I picked up the one with the head up. But they're really cute. This one from the is a roughly 6 inches tall and about 5 inches long. So that's one. But look how graceful that one is standing. Thank you. It was so nice to meet you too. Then we have this one here. This one is down eating. He's kind of more shy and bashful looking. But they're really, really nice. Very good detail on them. And the eyes and everything. It's very nice. And this pair is, number 13. And they are $20. Number 13, and it's $20. Number 13. So I'm looking for something very specific on my buck. Do you have a painted wooden recipe box? I think I might. Do you have something you can show while I go and see if I have that for Sue?
Yeah, but I want to teach you another StreamYard trick.
Okay.
So if it's click the, do you see the button where you can share your screen? You can share do this.
Okay, you don't share my screen. Not there.
Yeah, you see that? It's down at the bottom.
It's on the bottom.
Yep.
No, I see it says mute, stop, yep. Cam, mic, yep. And invite.
Yep. Oh, it doesn't say share.
I don't see a share button.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't see a share button.
Oh, maybe it's because you have the StreamYard, the other. Oh, you're on your iPad, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm on my iPad.
Oh, maybe it's on the computer. I was going to show you how you could share your screen if you wanted to do a quick search when somebody asked for something specific. Mm-hmm. You could screen and pull up Google and search for it.
Oh, no, I'm not that fancy.
You don't want to learn that?
Well, I'm trying on my laptop, but I don't see a share button down there.
Okay, it's probably on your laptop then.
Yeah, and I usually will do it on my, you know, I'll try it on my laptop one day.
Okay.
But I think I have, I'm just looking back there. No, I don't see it just out here. Because I'm trying not to open up too many boxes at once. I'm just
bringing. Yep.
Thank you, Anna. Oh, that's Karen leaving. Okay, Karen. Thank you.
So we'll, I'm going to write that down.
So I'll look up, Sue, and if I find it, I'll let you know in an email.
Me too.
Yeah, so I will do that. So the last item I had was this lady here.
All right, wait.
She is having errors.
Yeah, they want to refresh before you do this lady head.
Okay.
So let them refresh.
You're welcome.
Make sure you guys are in live chat.
I was buffering. I wonder if something going on with my computer, with my internet.
I don't know. Is your daughter watching?
I'm not getting any error messages, and I'm not seeing any buffering on my end.
Yeah, I'm not seeing it on mine either.
And usually I'll see it just, yes, everyone is buffering. Huh.
You're not missing it, Christina. You're okay. She's... Christina wants an opportunity to go after that head vase.
Okay. Where is D? I don't know. D got some nice ones, though, on Saturday.
Okay.
So is everybody's internet seem to be pretty stable right now?
Christina, if you're there, honey, you can bid by proxy. Just text me.
Okay, I'm going to go on. It keeps saying video. Lissa said that the video just keeps spinning and crashes. So I guess we're having some type of problem.
Huh.
Yeah, but see, usually I'll get an error message or something up there. Because she went in the house and now Joanne says she can't get back on. It keeps saying try later.
Hmm.
Let me see on this one right here. Let's see. I'm looking for my signal here. No, I'm looking at my phone. I have a very strong signal. And...
Oh. Well. Okay, but if you decide you wanna,
but on my computer, it's not a very strong signal. It just has two bars instead of the whole five.
Hmm. You wanna, are you streaming on your computer right now?
No, I was on my iPad.
Just on your iPad?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you want to do the head vase, Christina,
Sam just says it's good.
Okay.
Christina, I think it's a YouTube issue. So, okay, we'll go on with it then. What was you saying, Jan? I'm sorry.
Christina can't get back in. She says she'll start the bidding at $25.
I was going to go a little bit higher than that because of what I paid. If anybody want to bid on it, let me give you a description of it. Make me some offers and I'll let you know whether I'll accept.
Well, you can still do an offer up, honey.
Yeah, it's going to be an offer up.
What do you want to start her at?
What did I have on my paper? I had $40 starting bid.
Okay, let me.
Yeah, 40 is my starting bid. Joanne, if you want to, you can text me. You have my phone number. If you want to text me your bid, that'll be fine. And we'll just move a little slower because of technical issues. I don't know if you can see her, but this is her. She's really pretty, have beautiful eyelashes. She has gold earrings. Her paint is great. She does have a little crazing. It's marked, let me show you that on the bottom. That's the bottom.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's either YouTube or StreamYard.
Yeah.
Because I just
got back on my laptop, same thing is happening on my phone. So YouTube must be having an issue. Mm-hmm. So probably what we'll have to do is just put the sale on and call it for the evening since we're having.
Yeah, you want to? That's what I would do.
Wouldn't be there because I know quite a few people were waiting around you for this. And, yes. She, you know, and Joanne says she's tried several things and it's just not letting her do anything.
Same with Christina.
Yeah.
So I think that's a good choice.
Yeah. So I can't see the chat move with no video. She can see the chat move with no video.
Right.
That's weird. So you know, I hate to do this, but let's just call it an evening and thank everybody for coming. And
so
my sale on Saturday and I will include her in the sale for Saturday.
Okay, let me type that in. I'm typing that in now. We'll put her in Saturday sale. Due to technical difficulties.
And I'll put two of them in Saturday sale. I'll have two.
You rebel!
Yeah.
Let me type that in.
I'm hoping it can be Saturday. She is yellow and wonderful. Yeah, I'll have two of them in Saturday sale. And but I just don't think it's fair because I know some people, they came just for that. And if they can't get on and then it sell, you know, I'm thinking what I would want to do if I was a customer, what I would want it to happen.
Yep. Yeah. So, and I will... I'll be there on Saturday, and if people want to send me a proxy bid, so if you want to send me an email with the max that you want to bid, I will proxy bid for you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I appreciate it. I have to remember that for my sale on Saturday night. Did I have any little golden books, Rebecca? No, I didn't put in the show tonight. But what my plans is. I have so many books. I was going to do like a flash book sale and get rid of some books. I was going to do a flash book sale. I was going to do fabric and craft sales because I need to clear out some of this stuff.
I got lots of books.
It will be great prices and things when I do. So, but I'll keep everybody posted, but I am going to try to do something on my regular Saturday at noon. And then then just kind of keep this time slot 9 o'clock on Tuesday night. So again, and thank you everybody. And especially thank you, Jan.
You're welcome. You're like one of the easiest people to teach tech stuff to because you don't go crazy fast ahead and you take it slow and you figure it out. And you did great. You can have guests all the time now.
No, I don't know about that, but
so while people are still in here, just try that other button, the one where it puts the two windows like this, so you can highlight comments underneath.
Okay, so this try one that. Here.
Yep, that one, and now click on. There you go. Aw, you book. Look how fancy you are.
You know what, Nancy? Maybe you, Jan, and myself need to be having a fabric sale. I'm going to turn my camera around and don't look down on me bad, okay?
Uh-uh.
This is my secret corner.
Let it out, girl.
Can you see? I don't know if I turned it the right way or not.
Uh-huh.
But all of that, and do you see that pegboard wall over there? All of that's craft supplies. Over there is all craft kits in that corner. And yeah. up under my secret curtain, we won't discuss.
Nice. Yeah.
I mean, it's just like, whatever.
The three of us should do a collab sale on craft stuff.
Yeah, because I mean, it's, thank you, Terry. I mean, it's just like so much stuff.
And then after watching my videos, all of a sudden you're like, yeah, let me let it all hang out because this is not compared to what Jan's dealing with.
We moved from a large house, right? Four bedrooms, dining room, living room, kitchen, family room, den. And then I had a huge studio in my backyard. This studio is a quarter the size of my other one. So I gave away so much stuff when we moved, and I thought I was going to be able to, you know, get a large studio. But then when we moved, the largest building they would allow was a 12 by 12.
And that's your she shed.
Yes. So that's what, so I had to fit everything in there. So my garage is still piled up, but I still want to park in my garage. So I have boxes all the way around the perimeter of the garage.
Yeah.
And I haven't even started to unpack a lot of it. And then
now, do you have air conditioning in there?
No, I don't, but I do have a fan, and I'm not one of those people that turn the air on a lot. And
I am
to kind of plug air in out here. My other one was air conditioned, but it had a separate box and everything. This mm-hmm. one does not. And I don't gotcha. Know how much power it'll really take, but I know I had plugged my fan in last year and the fan did great.
Nice.
Yeah. So you know, so we're working on it, but I'm pleased. And every day I just say thank you that you know.
Grateful for life. Good life.
And I can see our Sunday chat being me playing with all the tech. Well, I'm going to be watching y'all on Sunday because I did learn a lot listening and everything to y'all discussion.
So let's lay out here. What time is your sale on Saturday?
My sale is always Saturday noon Eastern Standard Time.
Okay.
Now Jan's sale is tomorrow.
Mine's tomorrow night at 8:00. Yep.
And at 8:00 Eastern.
Yep. And then Thursday night, 11 p.m. is Nancy at this overstuffed house.
Yeah, 11. And Nancy, I would love to watch you, but you know.
It's late. Yeah.
It's late. But I catch you a few minutes and then I'm gone.
Yeah. And then Babes and I are going on vacation. And then, so after that, I think the three of us should do a collab craft sale.
That would be neat. Because I have a lot of craft followers on Facebook that would come over and watch that.
Nice. Yeah. There's a lot of craft kits here. I mean, I've got obviously more at my house, but, you know, here there's like wreath kits. There's old rug kits, vintage latch hook rug kits. And there's lots of like little crafty, pipe cleaners and ribbons and Google eyes and, you know, just lots. And I mean, I would love to unload some lots of craft stuff. That would be great. And I'm fabric. I know.
Pat, what are you doing tomorrow? I'm not doing a sale tomorrow. My sale won't be until Saturday, but I will be sending out your invoices tomorrow from Saturday or if you purchase something tonight.
Yep.
And that's a great idea. We could start putting that together, putting kits together or
let's give ourselves some time because I would really like to build up some like box lots. And I've learned Bates and I have learned from doing the first two sales that if your shipping boxes stay under 12 inches, so if you focus on a 12 by 12 by 12 box and make the lots that size, it'll be really able to ship.
Yeah. Because when I was doing my box lots on Facebook, I would pack them and then I would say, this lot is this price.
Yep.
And people really, really liked it.
Yeah. Yeah, and I would really like to unload large 12 by 12 by 12 boxes.
Yeah. And then I'm just thinking about what else,
how much space that would leave.
Lightweight items, I packed yep. everything that'll fit in a flat rate envelope. And that's a $7.95, yep. I think, to ship yep. those. So I yep. would just incorporate that in the price, and it was free shipping. And nice. People up, and they loved that. I mean, I saw
that's a great so idea.
Much. I mean, just so much like that.
So what do you normally charge for a box like that?
It depends on what's in it. Like mm-hmm. if it's like stamps and stuff, a bunch of rubber stamps. Mm-hmm. If it's the wooden rubber stamps, you don't get as many because they take up a lot of room. Like I would sell those, some of those boxes, sometimes $50.
Nice.
You know? And it would include yeah. their, you know, shipping usually. And I didn't use yeah. the large flat rate boxes because those were like $17.95, whereas yeah. usually the shipping was only $10 in a regular box or $8 if it right. was going to a close state.
Yep. Yep.
And that's so it just kind of depend on what boxes. And then I had some customers where they would say, well, Pat, I only can you make me a $20 box? So I said, yeah. sure, I'll make you a $20 box. I'd put like the napkins in it and
yeah.
paper, a little bit of everything. And
that's such a great idea.
A mystery box.
Yeah, I think that would be great. I mean, do you still do your Facebook page, right?
Yeah, yeah. I do a sale on Facebook every first Monday of every month on my Dollmakers Delight group.
And, nice.
You know, I have a pretty good, I do pretty good over there, but I, you know, those are like handmade dolls and handmade clothes and stuff like that.
That's so a big deal. That's a lot of work.
Well, it is. That's why I only do it once a month.
Oh, okay. You
know, then I don't do custom orders anymore. I just did one for a very good customer, but you know, I only want to do what I want to do.
And you're loving doing it.
I am.
You're
I am.
Loving doing it.
So when I want to get up and go, I can go. That's why I don't nice. Do customs anymore. Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was very nice. I enjoyed it.
You learned some techie stuff.
I did. I'm excited about that. I was trying to show my husband. He's like, okay, yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, but remember what we did before this earlier in the day when we were playing around backstage? You can do that anytime you want, even with your daughter.
Yeah, that's what's neat. I did not know that.
Yes.
Yeah, I didn't yep. know that part. So that was a great, that was, to me, that was the best tip ever.
Yep. And then you can even bring, because I think you have the free version of StreamYard, right?
Correct.
Okay. So you can bring up to 4 people in. Mm-hmm. Stage without going live, just playing around.
Right. Yeah, that was great.
Just to mess with cameras and stuff.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to do one with one of my friends that got on this evening.
Nice.
Me teaching her my little bit of knowledge.
Look at you, superstar tech support yeah. StreamYard. No, this is Patdoodles.
You know, she think I'm a genius. Okay,
you are a genius. Stuff.
And, you know, I built her website. I got her hooked on Etsy, help her get her Etsy shop up and all of that. You know,
yeah.
to me, she think I'm like, wow. And I'm going,
you are wow.
But I really didn't play around with the buttons because I didn't know you could do that stuff backstage without doing live. And, you know, yep. every time I thought nobody was watching live, it would be a few people would hop on. Not that I have a huge following, but several people would always get on.
Yeah.
So that was great knowledge right there. That was great. So I appreciate you so much. You just don't know. And thanks.
This was fun.
Good night, everyone that did join us. And we're sorry for the tech problems. That was beyond our control.
Yeah, that happens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, honey. I am. I'm gonna head out. I gotta go to work tomorrow, and then Babes and I are doing a sale at 8:00.
Okie dokie, then.
Turn on our channel.
Bye-bye.
Bye.